Hey everyone, it's Ivan with kitbachelor.com. Out here to tell you about my continued journey with this Gen 5 Glock 19 I got from Shooting Surplus. If you saw my first look video I did a while ago on my Gen 5 Glock 19 and new Radian barrel and comp, I ended up getting it, did a little bit of shooting, and actually ran into some issues. It was like version 1.0 of Radian's new barrel and comp, and they found some things after having a few of them out in the wild, and they're like, cool, like, let's improve upon that. And I'm not sure if kind of feed ramp geometry is one. I know coatings they ended up going through with some stuff, and yeah, kind of some different iterations. So I ended up getting a new barrel and comp out to do some more shooting with. That said, I also had that Gen 5 Glock 19, which was cool, right up to the point of like the factory dovetail protector. Glock sights are terrible. So ended up going into local shop up here, East County Guns. Cool guys up there, like they don't try and sell anyone like a tourist judge or something like that. And yeah, quickly and easily got the sights replaced. Ended up getting some nice hand-me-down sights from a buddy. Some, I think they're Heine, if memory serves, but actual tritium sights. And so once those got installed, ended up going out and doing a little more shooting. But dots are the way to go. And Primary Arms actually just came out with this guy right here. It's Holosun 509 something or other, but uses their ACSS Vulcan reticle, which I think is like the best of both worlds. On the one hand, you actually have an enclosed emitter. So when it's snowing and raining and stuff like that, you can just wipe it off. You won't get things in there that basically clog that emitter. And then on top of that, the Vulcan reticle. So when you present, you see, if you don't see your little chevron, you'll see part of a circle and it immediately gives you a correction. Really, really well thought out reticle. So had that and I needed to figure something out. Well, fortunately, again, that local shop, East County Guns, they work with a couple local companies. So picked up a card and promptly went and got some stuff done to this gun. Initially actually going, meeting up with over at Floyds Customs where they do all kinds of cutting on all kinds of different grunts. While the bread and butter of what they do is largely on like M&Ps, things along those lines, to include a lot of competition stuff, they pretty much work on everything, to include Walther PDPs, Glocks, whatever it may be. So ended up actually getting this slide cut for this optic. Really stoked, came out really well, sits really nice and deep in there. And when I end up finding a new rear sight, should actually be able to use basically just factory sights, factory height sights rather, and still be able to see it through this optic, which is really nice. With that, the one I originally had in here basically pushed back, so it wouldn't fit with the optic. But again, kind of companies working synergistically with each other. Floyd Customs, while they do a lot of cutting, they don't do any finishing work. So the people that handles all the finishing work is EDC Customs. Again, cool local company to me, and they did an amazing job. I ended up actually going, checking out their whole kind of facility shop setup. Pretty neat. They do a lot of really cool custom designs to include this pistol right here, which is basically like a space blaster now. It's like a stormtrooper gun. Pretty excited about it. So now that I have my Star Wars blaster, I'm gonna go get this thing zeroed, probably eventually make another trip back to East County Guns, actually get a rear sight that'll fit in there. And another thing that Radian kind of was trying to figure out is, hey, we made a really effective comp, which robs a lot of power from like the gun to cycle. So yes, we want it to run with a factory stock spring, but if it doesn't, why not build something better? So Radian actually made their own spring and guide rod. Everything's captured. Pretty cool, like pretty awesome design. So as I shoot through this more, see how it does with different ammo with basically that factory Glock spring, and then probably swap this guy out, throw that guy in there too. And again, do some more shooting with this. When I end up putting in more time with all of it, pistol, barrel comp, optic, all that stuff, I'll bring you guys a full review. But yeah, pretty stoked on my journey with this originally pretty vanilla Gen 5 Glock 19. This thing's pretty rad. But as always, thanks for joining us at kitbadger.com. Look forward to seeing you next time.